You know what? I wasn't gonna say anything about this, but TikTok keeps putting my videos under review, so I'm about to start some shit. I saw this a while ago when I was gonna mind my business, but it's getting ridiculous. TikTok, if you don't like my black ass, just go ahead and say it. There is a sound on this app where literally titties. Bro, and I mean they are there. They're visible right in front of you. Hold on. They just sit in there. Under this sound, which I'm not going to show because people are going to go run to go look, but I can't even show it, bruh. Oh, she pops her whole entire titty out. And this was posted then? It was posted in April and it's still up. But my video is under review because I'm wearing this. If you don't like bad bitches, say that, TikTok. Because I'm feeling like hate crime, bro. All you see is nipples. All you see is nipples under that sour. Am I the only person that has seen that? Why is no one talking about those videos? I really hate when I look good in a video and then there's those girls in the comment section that are like, I really hope this doesn't show up on his For You page. Shut the fuck up. Am I wrong for leaving my husband after I found out that he had cancer? So my husband and I had been married for about 10 years before we started becoming distant. A little while after, he actually cheated on me with one of my close friends. After that, nothing was ever the same between me and him. Now don't get me wrong, I still loved him, but things could never go back to the way they used to be. Eventually, he fell sick, started losing a lot of weight, having trouble breathing, getting random rashes on his skin. So we both agreed that he should go to the hospital to get checked. So he went to the hospital and had to wait a few days to get the results. A few days had passed, so he went back to the hospital to get his results. When he came back home, I asked him what his results where he said everything was fine, there was nothing to worry about. Then he put his keys on the counter and hopped into the shower. A couple days before, I had lost my credit card. I looked everywhere for it, couldn't find it, but the only place I didn't look was my husband's car. So I grabbed his keys while he was in the shower and I went to his car to look for my credit card. I was thinking maybe it fell out of my wallet while I was sitting in one of the seats. While I was looking for the credit card, I found a folder from the hospital he just went to. When I looked inside the folder, there was his test result. It was a biopsy test that confirmed he had cancer. So I went back inside to confront him for lying to me. Come back for part two. This is part two of the story of me leaving my husband after I found out that he had cancer. So after I found the positive test results in his car that confirmed he had cancer, I went back inside to confront him for lying to me. I was sitting down waiting for him to get out of the shower. But then I kind of decided that I didn't want to confront him. Our marriage was already going downhill and I was already having thoughts about leaving him anyway. I mean, he did cheat on me with my close friend. I know this might make me sound like a terrible person, but I didn't want to be there for him. I didn't want to be his main support system mentally or physically. And cancer is a lot to deal with. I didn't want to be in and out of the hospital, spending multiple days there, sleeping there, paying all of the bills myself. It would be too much for me. So I decided I was going to pack my things and leave without telling him when or why. And I mean, he didn't know that I knew he had cancer, so he wouldn't think that I was leaving him because of that. So I knew I needed to leave before he decided to tell me he had cancer, so it didn't look like I left him because of that. So the next day, he went to work, and then I went to work. As in packing all my stuff, and then I left. Afterwards, he kept begging me to come back, so I blocked him and I haven't talked to him since.
This is probably the most tragic and preventable airplane accident you'll ever hear about. The facts of this story are so shocking that when the audio of what led to the disaster was discovered, investigators and airline officials couldn't believe their ears. The audio of this disaster is so unsettling, but I will include it at the end of this story. On March 23, 1994, Aeroflight 593 was on its way from Russia to Hong Kong. On this flight, there were 63 passengers and 12 crew members, 9 of which were flight attendants. Then there were 3 pilots responsible for flying the plane. 2 of the passengers on board were 16-year-old Elder Kudrinsky and 12-year-old Yana Kudrinsky. And they were the son and daughter of Yaroslav Kudrinsky, who was one of the pilots on this plane. Yaroslav was taking his kids on their first international flight, and he was a proud pilot and wanted to show his kids his workplace, but he may have went a little too far. As they were nearing Hong Kong, Yaroslav invited his kids into the cockpit, which is the front of the plane where all of the controls are. This wasn't a problem until Yaroslav encouraged his kids to get into the captain's seat and take turns flying the plane. He would soon regret this decision. Part 2 of what happened to Aeroflight 593. So pilot Yaroslav Kudrinsky asked his 12-year-old daughter Yana if she would like to get into the pilot's seat and fly the plane. Yana was a bit scared, but her father encouraged her that it would be fine. Now, Yaroslav wasn't actually going to let her fly the plane. He would only make it seem like she was. Once she got into the pilot's seat, autopilot would be turned on. He would press some controls that would turn the plane slightly to the left, and it would feel like she was actually the one turning the plane to the left. She kind of felt the control handle turning itself, so she knew it wasn't actually her taking control. Once she was done, it was now his 16-year-old son Eldar's turn. Now, when Eldar got into the pilot seat, his dad messed with controls to make it seem like Eldar was flying the plane just like he did for Yana. Then he put the controls back to normal, which leveled the plane out. Then he left Eldar in the pilot seat and got distracted and started talking to his daughter Yana. While Yaroslav wasn't paying attention, Eldar was in the pilot seat, forcing the control handle to go into the direction that he wanted, which was fighting the autopilot, so the autopilot disconnected. Now, 16-year-old Eldar is actually in control and is flying the plane. Part 3 of what happened to Aeroflight 593. 16-year-old Eldar is in the pilot's seat of Aeroflight 593 while it's in the air after being given permission from his father, Yaroslav, who was a pilot on the plane. Eldar accidentally disconnects the autopilot and is now actually in control of flying the plane, which has 75 occupants in total. Yaroslav was completely distracted, so he didn't notice anything was wrong until Eldar asked, "Why is the plane turning?" In which Yaroslav responds, "Is it turning itself?" Eldar responds, "Yes." The plane is now at a sharp 90-degree angle and it keeps turning every second. At this point, Yaroslav should have immediately removed his son from the pilot seat and took control of the aircraft, but he didn't. He just stood over Eldar in the pilot seat, looking at the controls, trying to figure out what's wrong. Before they know it, the plane is going down at about 40,000 feet per minute. But the plane is going down at an angle. They're almost upside down. It's like going down the hill of a roller coaster, so they're being pinned back to their seats. Because of the amount of pressure from the plane going down, pinning everyone back to their seats, Eldar is unable to get out of the pilot seat. Part 4 of what happened to Aeroflight 593. Now, all Yaroslav can do is yell demands at his 16-year-old son, who has no knowledge on flying an airplane, so he can try and get the plane back on course before they all crash and die. The plane is being flipped in all different directions, upside down, on its side. The passengers are being tossed around like Caesar salad. Make sure to watch my Instagram story for the full animation and real audio recording. But I do warn you guys, it is very unsettling. Eventually, Yaroslav was able to get Eldar out of the seat and take control, but it was too late. The plane lost too much altitude and was flying too low and crashed into some mountains. There were no survivors. And what makes this even worse is that they were only 8 minutes away from their destination. After further investigation, they found that all Eldar had to do to keep the plane from going down was let go of the control handle, and the autopilot would have reconnected itself and set the plane back on course.
I met this boy on the BLK app. Let's get ready for this date. He's taking me out for dinner and a movie, so I'm gonna try to wear something cute and casual. Nothing too fancy, because we're not going to a fancy restaurant or anything. I should probably put my hair up. We back. Honestly, I'm not gonna lie to y'all. I'm a little nervous, because he's really cute and he's really tall. Ooh. But I'm also excited because we have a lot of the same interests. Can you come out? We listen to the same kind of music and we relate to a lot of personal things, like our beliefs and our values, like the way that we think. I met him on this app called BLK. I think you guys should download it because there's a lot of fine people on there. Like me. not too much. This is what I look like on my profile, so we gotta try and look like her. With her fine self. Oh, ain't she just so fine? I'm gonna finish my makeup off camera and I'll be back. Makeup's done, time to get dressed. Okay, so this is the outfit. I've been really into gray colors lately. And I put this jacket on because I think it looks really cute with the jacket. He's here, so it's time to go. Did I just spend $600 on some headphones? Yes, I did. Don't ask me why I bought it. It's my own motherfucking money, shut up. It's retail therapy. I don't have any friends, but I got money, so I'ma spend it. Please excuse my ghetto setup. I don't have one of them aesthetic backgrounds right now. Oh, it's supposed to go this way, okay. I love Apple boxes. I'm gonna keep this, like I'm not even gonna throw it away. Okay, the moment of truth, oh my God. I love the packaging so much. I'm obsessed, actually. I feel like everyone thinks the green ones are ugly, but I think they're so cute. I feel like it looks better than any of the other colors. The case is not very protective, I'll tell you that. They clack together, and so I'm gonna have to buy one of those like clear cases that go over the metal part. Let's do some ASMR. Yo, you cannot hear shit. Hello? 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 Oh my gosh. I'm gonna connect it to my iPad and play some music. We gonna play some Onika Mirage. You wanna F-R-E. Wait a damn minute. Oh, this shit feel like I am Nicki Minaj, like I'm the one rapping. I feel like it's a 10 out of 10. I really like it. You ain't nothing but a dog.
The Chic Glam Matte Foundation. So many different shades. Hey, girl, I can lick it, I can ride it while you cover it and slide it. Can do all them little tricks and keep the dick up inside it. You can smack it, don't cover it. You can go down and kiss it. And let's see how it looks with the rest of my makeup on. He miss it. He wanna F-R. Result looks so smooth and feels amazing on my skin. Trying to style my short for sea hair with no heat or gel. Style 1, this is cute. Style 2, super easy, but makes my head look big. Well, and if you have a question.
y'all have heard about this new viral wig that has been going around. It's from Gorgeous Hair. I think that's how you pronounce it, but I'm about to try it on today. Is it really gonna be worth the hype? Let's find out. And y'all know one thing I'm not gonna do is lie to y'all. I got the 4x4 unit. It's bohemian style, supposed to give you that wild and free look. It said it was gonna come pre-plucked and pre-bleached, and by the looks of it, that's accurate. The lace is already tinted as well, so all you're supposed to do is cut the lace, put it on, and go. So that's what we're about to do. Okay, ignore my hair right now. I still look cute bald, so I don't want to hear nobody say nothing. I don't want to hear nobody saying nothing about my bald head, because I still look good. So I'm going ahead right now, and I'm just cutting the lace. Let me put this back on, because I know y'all finna say something about my bald head, and I really don't want to hear it. Anyways, so the lace has been cut, so now I'm about to try it on. I'm going to see how well this blends. So they said no glue, so literally just cut the lace, put it on. Wait, hold on.
Doing a little 360 for y'all.
So what do y'all think? Is it gorgeous or not? Y'all, I have been hearing so much about this She Glam liquid blush, and I wanted to try it out today for myself. This is what the packaging looks like. I think it's really unique. I've never seen anything like this before. I think it's really cute. So when you actually open the blush, it comes with its own applicator, and it's in this sponge-like texture, which I feel like is better to apply your blush rather than using a regular brush. I heard that this blush blends out really well, so I'm gonna try to use it not only as a blush, but as contour and eyeshadow. Let's put this blush to the test and see how well it really blends out. So I'm using the shade Swipe Right, and I'm just applying it where I usually apply my contour. So put it right here and right here, and just a little bit right here. Now we're gonna blend it out to see if it does the trick. All right, wait, hold on y'all. Wait a minute, what? Look how good that is contouring my face right now. I really did not expect it to blend this well. Now I applied it as blush. Okay, oh my god, this is just too good. Get out of my face. Like, now as eyeshadow, I am literally in love. There's no way. Wow, I think I just found my new favorite product.